I fell on the playground when I was 4 years old, and so I was diagnosed with osteosarcoma at that point. So they, you know, immediately took me to Sloan Kettering up in New York City and amputated. So that's when I lost my leg.
Ashley is a hip disartic patient, which means that she's lost her limb at the hip level. So besides the hip and the knee joint and the ankle, she's got a lot to contend with.
When you're missing three joints, you know, your hip, your knee, your ankle, versus missing one or two, it does really change things. So everything from, you know, hills and steps, you know, everything is a little bit different for a hip disarticulate amputee. A casting is a pretty basic thing. When you're a kid and you grow every 6 months, they recast you. So I've been through, in 25 years, I have been through so many castings. And so today was different as far as it was just a lot less. Usually they're going, you know, from here down to cast you, and today it was just so, there was so little bit. So I'm really excited to see the difference in the weight.
So we got involved with working with Ashley and going through the typical procedures. We still were falling short of her expectations. Her goal was to walk without use of a forearm crutch, and so eventually we went down to the University of Delaware with the Bader department, and utilizing the motion capture analysis, we were able to compare her existing prosthetic with what we currently made for her. And there were still some things that we just couldn't clinically figure out.
And I would seem to run into a lot of, you're working like a man, and you're doing things that women shouldn't be doing. And I was like, well, you know, yeah, I'm breaking the leg, but what would you tell me if I were a man? There's got to be some technology that I can be as active as I want to be without breaking it.